And welcome back, guys. So we're going to continue playing some more Dishonored. Really enjoying the gameplay. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure that... thank you guys for supporting the channel. I'm trying to change how our intros are. It's a work in progress. Anyways, let's do some more gameplay of some Dishonored. Yikes, that's a rough start. Let's try that again.
Nasty fat and sinew, and carve a pretty song on your bones.
Hey! Someone kill this crazy witch! I could make you rich!
Quiet now. Granny needs to concentrate.
Don't kill me. Grannyrag, stop! Stop what you're doing. Can't we at least talk about it?
My knife's gotta be nice and sharp to cut into your... There's my love. Are you ready to help get Slackjaw's bones? Granny has some birthday gifts for you. I've been saving them up in case you ever came back to me. Aren't you a gentleman helping Granny Rags with her stew? We'll eat well tonight, sweetheart. First thing, you'll have to put him to the knife. Don't want him crawling out of the pot now.
What you doing? Listen, Omnicorvo, don't help her! Don't let her kill me!
You can have anything I own. First.
Corn, whiskey, I got a key to the sewer ways. Whatever you want!
Kill him first, my love. Then we can remove the chains.
What are you doing? Don't help her. She's out of her mind. I can reward you. What do you want? Money? Weapons? She'll do the same to you. There's no dealing with her. She's mad. But you...
Unlock his chains for me, darling. Here's the key. And unlock his chains now, dearest. That's right. Pick him up and toss him right in the pot. Go on. You're so young and strong, dearie. It won't be any trouble for you to pick him up and get him into that pot. Oh, thank you. What a fine help you've been. I'll just let him stew a while now. Go ahead, darling. Take your presents and go. Granny's got things to do.
You find your way into such interesting places, crawling out of those flooded ruins, winding your way back to the pub where you last saw Emily. Where is she now? How does it feel now, knowing your allies betrayed you? Strange how there's always a little more innocence left to lose. And Dowd, you just killed the greatest assassin of the age. Did you do it for love of the Empress or Emily? Or was it the primal desire to rise above other men? Do you even know why?
you, Corvo. Thank the stars. We all thought you'd been killed. Except for Samuel. He seemed sure you'd survived. I saw him on the river shortly before the killing began. He was smart enough not to come ashore. But I'll bet he's still out there. Looking for you is my guess. Havelock called us into the yard. But I wasn't feeling well. I just watched from the attic. The Admiral brought his cutlass. He stuck Wallace through the eye with it. Then he did Lydia. Callista he shot in the back with his pistol. Emily saw it all. Havelock kept yelling something about the things he'd done and how no one could ever know. Pendleton wouldn't even look anyone in the face. They said it was time for Sokolov and went off to his cage. I don't know what happened after that. Emily was... Lydia's the only one who ever showed me any kindness.
If you ask me, he's long gone. In the river, that's what a rational person would do. Not this guy. You have to understand. I called him to go. The whole time they were working with him, I heard they locked him in a cage and only let him out at night.
Criminal mind.
Ever closer until...
Cut it out. What's so impressive about Corvo anyway? Who's he got up against? A couple of high overseers? A couple of noblemen? He could never stand up to men with our training.
Oh, now I do hope he shows up. I want to see you run crying from cover. Boys out back.
Like you are.
Here. You're gonna bleed, damn you!
refreshing to converse with someone.
I couldn't agree more. Your expulsion from the Academy was a crime against natural philosophy itself.
Which you might have pointed out at the time. But it's pointless to hold a grudge. I want to ask...
Corvo, good to see that you still breathe. The city would not be the same if you were not with us. I've completed Piero's work on an arc pylon, but only just.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, nearly rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes. I've attuned it so that we will be safe from the functions of the device. It will only trigger in the presence of our enemies. This arc pylon is more powerful than the older design. It will function at a greater range, striking down our foes while ignoring us. I need my final sequence, which is recorded in the blueprint for this device. Havelock was inspecting it before the killing started. Return the blueprint to me. It was in his bedroom before he left. Hopefully, it's still there. You may navigate the fields. I'll make what you need as long as I have the necessary materials. astonishing. The arc pylon is complete. Now to activate it.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, nearly rendering our enemies unconscious. Or they can be reduced to ashes.
What is your opinion, Corvo? I should have guessed you'd want to act decisively. It's a simple adjustment, and we will be ready. All is ready, Corvo. All that remains is plugging in a whale oil tank to power it. Will you do the honor?
When this arc pylon is charged, no one will dare come near us.
Destruction on a grand scale. Defies description. So many lives silenced in an instant.
Well, Corvo, I hope we can be considered colleagues again. You were condemned, I was kidnapped. Men like us rise above such things. As to the good Admiral, I believe men such as Havelock start with high-minded intentions. Same with Martin, and maybe even Pendleton, though I suspect he was just lazy. But no one is prepared for the sheer seductive...
Attention, Dunwall citizens. With sad hearts, the City Watch must announce the death of the Lord Regent, Hiram Burrows. May his...
Anyway, guys, this looks like a good place to stop. Make sure you hit that like button. Thank you guys for supporting the channel.